Hey there. Today I'm going to talk to you about the differences between MailChimp and ActiveCampaign from the perspective of a recovering web developer. That's me.
Let's take a look how the subscriber counts are different whether you're in MailChimp or ActiveCampaign. In MailChimp, in this example, we're going to assume that you have a service-based business that's online and we have three different landing pages dumping people into three different matching subscriber lists. This is a picture of me. You can clearly see that I am the same person, but in MailChimp, because I'm in this list, and this list, it sees me as three different people, aka subscribers, aka contacts. If we go over here to ActiveCampaign, same scenario, three different service landing pages with matching lists. I'm still the same person, but ActiveCampaign sees me as the same person because I am. It knows that I'm just interested in different things, but I'm still the same person. In MailChimp, the same person across three lists would be three contacts or subscribers. ActiveCampaign, the same contact, three different lists, one subscriber. So let's talk a little bit about some terminology. I'm going to cover three different types of terminology, contact, campaign, and automation for both MailChimp and ActiveCampaign. In MailChimp, this comes back to what we discussed earlier. It counts a contact as a person with one email address in a particular list. And that is key because, again, if a person is in two different lists, it's two contacts. They have different categorizations. A campaign, MailChimp offers different types of email campaigns. It could be a regular email, something that's automated, a plain text email, or an A/B test. And that's comparing whether one email works better than another. You can also create an ad campaign using Facebook or Instagram or a Google remarketing ad campaign. They also recently offered landing page campaigns. And then finally, in automation in MailChimp is an email or a series of emails sent to a contact based on a specific trigger. Now, what is a trigger? This is something that causes an event or situation to occur. In ActiveCampaign, a contact is a unique email address. It's not a person with a particular email address in a particular list. A contact is just a unique email address. A campaign in ActiveCampaign is either a standard email, it could be an autoresponder, a split test email, RSS triggered email, or a date-based email. An automation in ActiveCampaign is a chain of events. And it runs when it's triggered by certain conditions. When a particular email is opened, a site message, you can even send a text message, let somebody know they open an email. There's different logic. You can even string together multiple automations. You could start one automation and then begin another one. It gets really powerful when you start combining triggers, actions, and logic together. The last thing I want to cover is how you can customize messages that you send out to people in your marketing platform. Let's start with ActiveCampaign first. If you remember back in our earlier example, when we were talking about how many contacts ActiveCampaign counts each person in a list, in ActiveCampaign, you would actually not organize your email marketing this way. What you would end up doing is you can determine how a person got in your list based on what they chose to subscribe to. So these right here would be eliminated. It would just be one person and it would become this. You would have one overall leads list, for example, and you would be able to determine a person in the list came to you because they subscribed to receive, maybe you gave away a bonus ebook this person came on the list because they wanted a worksheet that was tied to a certain blog post you wrote. And this person came on the list because they subscribed to receive a holiday coupon. Now, any one of these could have found this by landing on one of your service pages on your website, but this is how you know how they got there. This is the big difference with ActiveCampaign and MailChimp. By using tags to mark in your database how the subscriber came to you, that is a big way you can target your marketing. In MailChimp, with that same example from earlier, you have to set a particular list for a subscriber to go into. You can't tag a characteristic of that person. You have to set a particular list and then use groups and segmentation. But there's no way to do the tagging like you can in ActiveCampaign to really drill down and do some targeted marketing. As you can see, it just depends on where you are in your journey. MailChimp is perfectly awesome in the beginning stages. You have a simple newsletter. You have a couple different groups. Super simple. It's easy to use, and you can use it for a long time before you build up your subscriber base. If you want to send targeted messaging particular to how your subscribers want to receive information, you can do some super fancy automation email series. I highly recommend ActiveCampaign as the way to go.